Hi guys, welcome to the channel. Hope you guys are having a really good day. I don't know what's happening right now, but my motivation for uploading YouTube videos is like really, really high. I think it's because I've taken a step back from streaming. Over the last week and a half, I've just not been streamed at all. It's because I was getting really burnt out of Dauntless because I was playing it quite a lot. And I don't know, man, I'm happy with the way they've reworked the sword and just other things. Really refresh my mental state of the game. Just make me play a bit more. So I'm really happy with the way Phoenix Labs has done some of the changes recently. If you guys don't follow me on Twitch, I'll leave a link down the bottom. Feel free to come check me out. I will be making a return on Twitch on the Thursday with some solo trials. So definitely come check me out if you wish to do so. Obviously, I've been uploading a lot of YouTube videos recently, actually one every day for the last 3 days. Today will be the fourth in a row, I believe. Not because I'm just pumping it out for the sake of it. I just actually really enjoy making them at the moment, and it's really good ways to look back and just be like, oh, I'm actually improving at certain things, like thumbnails, stuff like this. I think I'm improving in certain areas, and I'm liking the way it's changing. It's not perfect, but I'm definitely liking the way my channel's going. Today I've got you a video which is based on a glass cannon build. If you are unfamiliar with the term glass cannon, it basically is the term in the community that you run a really, really low life deficit build, which is really, really risky to run. But at the same time, rewards the slayer if you can keep your predator up and just if you're not dying constantly over and over. You can get one shot from a lot of behemoth attacks. That's why it's called glass cannon. You can just die straight away off the rip. But one executed properly, this build is devastating and probably one of the best DPS builds in the game. Yes, I will say that. And when I do post this to Reddit and people will be like, this is UI, this UI, I don't care. This does so much damage. You have your own thoughts. I have mine. The proof is in the pudding, as they say. I'm going to put through you to some runs in a bit, and all the variants of the runs are all heroic. This build works for heroic plus, but it just requires a bit more high level skill. The Slayer, I can do it, but I thought I'd do just heroic version just to show how devastating the daggers can come. I've put in a Rezakiri in there just to show that all the behemoths before that are on the heroic scale. I'm not just blabbing saying, oh, this is doing this, here's this build, I'm running dyers, I'm running like lessers. No, they all have rogue variants. If you guys don't believe me, come check out the stream. We do a lot of solo stuff as well, and just I warm up with a lot of solo heroic pluses, so I'm not just talking rubbish. So yeah, anyway, the build goes a bit like this. It's a Tordegoro slash Hellion build. You can run Hellion instead of Tordegoro if you don't have the Tordegoro's upgrade to plus 15 or plus 10 actually, because that's all you need to get the plus 3 bond of each for plus 3 ability of the Hellion. So we've got Overpower, Discipline, Titan's Crash, Psychonic Strike Plate, and obviously the bond of Hellion Flames. Then we've got the Hellion Helmet with Berserker, Koshai Chest with Catalyst, Molkarian Arms with Berserker, Karog Feet with Rage, and then the Drask Lantern with the Catalyst. You could run Embermane and Pangas Lantern, but this build was supposed to be raw damage and just hit like a truck, and that's what I've done. I put in Drask Lantern for that 30% extra damage on tap for 6 seconds. That can increase your damage output hugely, so I'd recommend going for that if you are trying to see those big numbers. The perk overview goes like this: plus 6 of Berserker, Catalyst, Overpower, Predator, Rage, leaving plus 3 Discipline and plus 3 Rage Hunter. All the runs I'm going to put you through, do none of them ironically don't go into Rage. I actually kill it before they go in Rage. Before you start writing a comment saying, oh, you've got Rage Hunter, you're not even utilizing it. No, I'm not utilizing it in these fights. But Rage Hunter was left as a perk. I could have run plus 6 Discipline, but I would rather run the plus 3 Rage Hunter because not all runs are perfect. And it's better to have a cushion of damage. And if you do, like most fights do, you don't run a perfect fight, but that Rage Hunter plus 3 is to give you that extra bit of damage. 15% actually, that's quite a lot. Especially with all of this in play, it does a lot of damage. So I'll leave the link to the build in the description below. That goes to my Discord and to my Twitch as well. So definitely go check those out. Hope you guys are going to enjoy the rest of your day, because I got some nice food here, so I'm going to enjoy that. I'm going to put you through to the run. Enjoy the rest of the video. Leave it a like. Subscribe if you're new. All of that business. And I'll see you guys in the next video, which will be this one, by the way. It will be uploaded in the next couple of days. Probably not tomorrow because I've got an interview. So yeah, fingers crossed I get a job there. But if not, regardless, once again, guys, for the rest of the day, thank you very much for watching.
desire. I wanna take you right there.
Take you out.